We are from Electronics and Communication Department and we are going to demonstrate you about the microwave test bench. So what is a microwave test bench? The general parameter, which is a general setup for the measurement of various parameters in microwave, this is called as the microwave test bench. Now the microwave test bench comprises of a range of instruments and components which are capable of allowing all types of measurements and calculations which are required for the microwave engineer. Now the microwave test bench is capable of being disassembled and assembled according to our needs, according to the instrument.
It is a block diagram of microwave test bench setup. First, generator power supply, then the generator, that isolator, variable, frequency meter, slotted section, crystal, component under test, then VSWR meter, which is voltage standing wave ratio.
Now this is klystron power supply. It generates voltage which is required for driving the reflex klystron tube 2K25. It is a stable, regulated and short circuit protected power supply. It has a built-in facility of square wave and sawtooth generators for amplitude as well as the frequency modulations. Now the beam voltage may be continuously varied and is indicated on the front panel. Then it has a beam voltage can range from 200 volts to 450 volts and as well as the current, it has a maximum beam current of 50 milliampere. Now the provision is given to vary the Rappler voltage continuously from 270 volt DC to 10 volts. An external modulation may be used through the UHF connector provided on front panel. Now these are the gun diodes and the pin diodes. If we want to calculate the voltage as well as power and the characteristics of the gun diode and the pin diode, then we need to connect the gun power supply instead of the klystron power supply. Now the gun power supply has a voltage which is ranging from 0 to 10 volt, has a current of 750 milliampere maximum, has a modulation frequency of 900 to 11 hertz. Now this is a gun oscillator, and gun oscillators are solid state microwave energy generators. These consist of waveguide cavity flanged on one end of the micrometer driven and micrometer driven plunger fitted on the other side. A gun diode is mounted inside the waveguide with a BNC connector for DC bias. Each gun oscillator is supplied with calibration certificate giving frequency versus micrometer reading. It has a frequency range of 8.5 to 11.5 GHz. It has a load VSWR of 1.5 maximum, frequency stability of 500 kHz degree Celsius temperature. Isolator is a two-port device. Now this device permits unattenuated transmission in one direction, that is the forward direction, but it provides very high attenuations in the reverse or the backward direction. This is generally used between the source and the rest of the setup to avoid overloading of source due to reflected power. It has a frequency range of 8.6 to 10.6 or 10.2 to 12.2. It has a minimum isolation of 20 dB and a maximum insertion loss of 0.4 dB and it has a maximum VSWR of 1.20.
The device that detonates the signal is termed as attenuator. Attenuator is categorized in two categories. First one is a fixed attenuator and second is a variable attenuator. Variable attenuator consists of a strip of absorbing material which is arranged in such a way that its profusion into the guide is adjustable. Hence, the signal power to be fed into the microwave setup can be set at the desired level. This is known also as flap attenuator. Next comes the frequency meter. Frequency meter is basically an absorption cavity resonator. The cavity is connected to a waveguide. The cavity can be made to resonate at source frequency by adjusting its size by rotating the dial of frequency meter. The frequency can be read from the direct reading frequency meter. Next comes the slotted section. In slotted waveguide section, the longitudinal slot is cut into the top of the section of waveguide. These sections are used to tuners or to match the waveguide. The slot must be greater than the half wavelength for the lowest group wavelength. The slot is located along the plane of maximum electric field for TE is equal to 10 ohm.
Now the next component we have the crystal detector. Crystal detector is basically called as tunable detector. Tunable detector is very simple and easy to use as an instrument for finding the microwave power. It has a frequency range of 8.2 to 12.5 GHz.
consists of a detector crystal mounted in a section of the waveguide and shorting plugger for matching purpose. It is the simplest and the most sensitive detecting element in the microwave crystal diode, since the current flowing through the crystal is proportional to the square law detection property of the crystal, is valid at a low power level. It has a frequency range of similar to the microwave, that is 8.2 to 12.4 GHz. Now, the next component we have is a SWR meter. SWR meter is a voltage standing wave ratio, is the ratio of voltage at the high, and SWR meter is high gain tuned amplifier, operating at a fixed frequency of 1 kHz. It is designed primarily for use in conjunction with suitable detector. This is also be used for impedance measurements, relative power level measurement at the bridge circuit, and in other applications requiring for the sensitive fixed frequency indicator. It is directly show the value, that is SWR or in dB. We will give input, that is 220 volt AC, and we connect this with BNC cord, and it has a bandwidth of 50 Hz. Now, the precautions for this experiment is, during operation of klystron, Doppler should not carry any current. Therefore, negative voltage is also applied before applying the anode voltage. Otherwise, Doppler will be damaged if electrons are bombarded on the Doppler. While measuring power output, the frequency meter should be detuned. To avoid loading of the klystron, an isolator should be connected between klystron and the rest of the setup. Do not look into the waveguide during operation, because microwave energy emitting out the waveguide can damage the retina. To have a good accuracy of the power level should be around 40 or 50 dB in VSWR meter.